ना गणपति हवामहे कविकवीनापमश्रवस्तम ज्येष्ठराज ब्रह्मणा ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्वन्वन्मोतिभिस्सीद सादरम् श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। ओम आप्यायन्तु ममांगानि सर्वं ब्रह्मोपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकर्याम् मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्व निराकरणं मे अस्तु। तदात्मनि निरतेय उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु। ओम शांति शांति शांति। सो सहा स्वराट भवति, ही बिकम्स स्वराट द सोवराइन इंडिपेंडेंट फ्री लिबरेटेड जीवन नेवा वाइल लिविंग। सो जीवन मुक्ति, वी एक्सेप्ट जीवन मुक्ति, वी डू नॉट टॉक ऑफ ए मुक्ति आफ्टर डेथ। यू नो सम रिजल्ट विच हैज टू कम आफ्टर डेथ, दट इज देयर ऑल अलॉन्ग इन कर्मकांड एंड उपासना कांड, द रिचुअल सेक्शन एंड इन द मेडिटेशन सेक्शन और उपासना सेक्शन, ओनली दट इज देयर ऑल द टाइम यू टॉक ऑफ ए रिजल्ट विच विल कम आफ्टर डेथ। इन द मेडिटेशन सेक्शन, दट मीन्स इन द भक्ति और उपासना कांड, देर इज ऑलवेज ए दृष्ट फलम असोसिएटेड। You see, there is a gradation in the result also. In Karmakanda, the result is always postponed for the later life. As of now, I do a ritual and end up with a lot of pain. That is all the drushta phalam. So, but I bear with the pain out of enthusiasm because I have a value for the ritual. The result will wait. Then in upasana, means in bhakti, the result is there now also, drushta phalam, and also later. Now the drushta phalam is the calmness of mind, some composure, and a few good values getting established in the mind. They bring joy in their way. So this way, very very many good results are there now and here, drushta phalam. Of course, like even rituals, the upasana brings some higher, great result after the fall of the body. But when it comes to Vedanta, entire phalam is now and here. So jivanneva swarad bhavati, you become the king while the person is alive. Patitepi dehe swaradeva bhavati, suppose the body falls, then what happens? Then also he continues to be swarat only, because in this creation there is only one swarat, that is Ishvara, and the jnani is one with Ishvara, therefore he continues to be swarat. Then the mantra says, tasya sarveshu lokeshu kamacharo bhavati. So he will have free access to all the worlds. That is the vakyam. It sounds quite interesting. We will see what Bhashyakara says. Yata evam bhavati, tata eva tasya sarveshu lokeshu kamacharo bhavati. सो यतहा एवं भवति, मीन्स यतहा जीवन्नेव स्वराट भवति, बाय लिविंग इटसेल्फ ही बिकम्स स्वराट वन विथ ईश्वरा, देयरफॉर तत एव फॉर दैट रीजन एलोन तस्य सर्वेषु लोकेषु कामचारो भवति, ही विल हैव ए टोटली फ्री एक्सेस इन ऑल द वर्ल्ड्स। दैट मीन्स द आइडिया इज, सपोज स्पेस इज देयर नाउ, if a person has to go to heaven, he has to travel from here to heaven. If space has to go to heaven, how much travel it has to do? It need not travel, because space is everywhere. In fact, everywhere is in space. Therefore, space need not travel to reach heaven. The joy of heaven, is it available to space or not? It is. This is how swarat. So the joy of heaven is everything. He is all. So the joy of heaven is available to him. If there are certain levels in heaven, then the joy of all those levels is available to him. That is the idea of sarveshu lokeshu kamacharo bhavati. On the other hand, if there is a limited being, If he is in heaven, then he gains the joy of heaven alone, and he misses the joy of earth. For example, if he is a soccer fan, then he misses all the soccer. In heaven, if he sits in heaven, then there is no soccer available in heaven. So that joy is not available to him. He can have any amounts of joy of heaven, but those of the earth are denied to him. So this is what is called. So tasya tavata kamacharo bhavati. That is, we have seen earlier. So to which extent your upasana takes you, to that extent you can go. Beyond that you cannot go. Whereas atmajnani, for him it is a free access. It is like world citizen. You know, some of these United Nations people, they are called world citizens, Kofi Annan, etc. They don't need visa and all that. If Kofi Annan wants to visit India, he doesn't need visa. He can just come to India. Because they are designated as world citizens. Similarly, World Health Organization people, UNICEF people, like that, they will be given a badge, like we get passport. And once they show that badge, all the member countries are accessible to him. Whereas for us, we have to take visa from one place to the other place. So we don't have that free access. Because we are limited to an area. Whereas he is a world citizen. He can go anywhere. So similar to that, this Brahma, it's not that Brahmajnani will be standing in one place now and he goes elsewhere. That is not the idea. He is one with all. All is in him. That's why Sarveshu Loka. That point is presented in a very characteristic way as Sarveshu Lokeshu Kamacharo Bhavati. Shankara explains it. Pranadishu, Purvabhumishu, Taprasyeti, Tavanmatra Parichinna Kamacharatvam, Uktam, Anyarajatvancha, Arthapraptam, Satishayatvat. Yeah. So, earlier there are various steps, like a staircase it was presented. In all those steps, in every one of them, it was presented this way. If you do this upasana, pranaha brahmetyupasita. For example, prana is Brahman. Mano brahmetyupasita. Like that. So if you do that, depending upon the nature of the upasana, there every mantra has got, every step has got a phalavakyam. Tatrasya kamacharo bhavati. Like that. So for this upasaka, for this meditator, there is free access in the area or in the domain of that particular thing. Whether it, if it is prana, then he has freedom in the domain of prana. Or in fact, earlier to that, if it is asha or manaha or buddhihi or smaraha, whatever it is, in that particular domain, he has totally free access. Whereas, and then that is only there. Tavanmatra parichinna kamacharatvam. He has also free access, but within that domain. It is like the citizen of a country. He is free to go anywhere in that country. But if he wants to cross the border, he needs documentation. He is not allowed. Within the country, he can travel any nook and corner. So similarly, within that area of upasana, he is free. But outside that area, he is not free. That kind of a kamacharatvam, a limited free access, is presented in the earlier mantras. And once you say he is limited in a given area, that phalam is limited, then one more characteristic is also comes into it. That is called anyarajatma. That means there is always somebody over his head. He has to live under the command of somebody, wherever he goes. On the earth, he lives. So as long as he lives, he is a citizen of a given country, and so he has to follow those laws, whether he likes or not. If he goes to heaven, then he becomes a denizen of heaven and he has to follow the laws of heaven. If Indra comes, he has to stand up. Otherwise, Indra will punish him. He will not tolerate that kind of indolence. He is not going to tolerate. So this way, anya rajatvam, he will never have that freedom. The idea is, he will continue to be a limited being and hence his happiness will be limited. Arthapraptam. This anyarajatvam was not mentioned earlier. He will have a domain here. He can travel anywhere. He can have access to anything. Like that it was said. But Anyarajatvam means there is always somebody on your head. That was not mentioned there. But artha praptam, it follows automatically. It need not be separately mentioned. Because he is not totally liberated. He is a limited being and hence functions under the command of higher forces. Satishayatvat. Wherever that domain is there, there is something superior to that. That kind of a thing is pointed out earlier. Therefore, the Anyarajatvam is understood. Okay. Whereas here, those two factors are denied. The Swarat, he is not having any problem in gaining access to anywhere. That means he is one with everything. He has the joy that is universal. That is the Swarat. And also, there is no Anya Raja for him. He is the Swaraja, Swarat, Swayam Raja, Swasya Raja. He is the king of himself, himself. That is how it is, Swarat. So that Anya Rajatvam is not there. That means, he reached a joy where you cannot have some other joy superior to it. Therefore, whatever happiness we have, that is marred by looking at something superior to it. So that problem, that kind of a limitation in happiness is not there for him. And hence we call it Ananta, infinite. So that is what Shankara says. Anyarajatvam satishayatvat arthapraptam. That was there in the earlier stages. Whereas here, yathaprapta swarajya kamacharatvanuvadena, tattan nivurti rihochyate sa swaraditya. So here what is the meaning of this swarat? It's not that he becomes a king, etc. He continues to be another limited being. That is not the idea. It is only nivurti. The nivurti is like this. If you do a particular upasana, say nama brahmetyupasita, your result is limited. And so your joy is limited. Now that limitation is not there for this jnani, nivurti. Then, suppose you do Asha Brahma, Asha is Brahma, that kind of upasana. Then he gets a higher joy, but still limited. So that limitation also is not there for this jnani. Therefore, we have seen a staircase like a series of things, some 10 or 15. Each has its own limitation in a joy. And those limitations are absent for this jnani. Because the whole thing is coming in a sequence. And in every step we have seen a kind of limitation on the joy that can be derived. So yatha prapta, whereas that kind of a limitation can be taken for this also, because it comes in that series. So that kind of a limitation is negated. No limitation. It is unlimited. So how to say unlimited? Two ways. One, there is no limitation of kamacharatvam. Everywhere free access. That is one way of negating the earlier limitation. The second way of negating is a swarat. In the earlier cases, there is anyarajatvam. There is somebody sitting over your head, which amounts to saying that you are a limited being. So that anyarajatvam is absent in the case of jnani. Therefore, he is a swarat. So the entire idea is the jnani's joy has no bounds. That's why we have to try to get it. That is the idea. Tattan nivurtiriha uchyate sa swaraditya. So that is about jnani. Then, what about ajnani? A comparison. In the mantra it is there, atha means in the opposite case, ye ataha anyatha viduhu. So, the knowledge of division is being decried here. That kind of a knowledge of division. Anyatha viduhu. They know differently. They do not know the way it is presented here. What is it is presented here? Atma idagum sarvam. That is what is presented here. There is no second. Atma alone is everything. Everything shines in Atma. Everything exists in Atma. So shining and existing, they go together. Whatever shines, that alone exists. And whatever exists, that alone shines. Therefore, they go together. So, the Atma is everything. And he knows that. And he becomes a Swarat. And his joy knows no bounds. Agreed. Atha, on the other hand, ये अतः अन्यथा विदुः, दोस पीपल हु टेक आत्मा टू बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट इज सेड हियर मीन्स आत्मा लिमिटेड, दैट इज हाउ दे टेक. ओके, गुड इनफ. वाई यू से आत्मा इज लिमिटेड? देर मस्ट बी सम रीजन. आत्मा इज लिमिटेड, वाई यू से? या यू सी आई एम 6 footer, सो दैट इज द लिमिटेशन ऑफ द बॉडी. वाई यू सुपर इम्पोज द लिमिटेशन ऑफ द बॉडी ऑन द आत्मा? आर यू द बॉडी? यस आई एम द बॉडी. देन यू आर मिस्टेकन. बॉडी इज इट नॉट बिकमिंग एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ यूर अंडरस्टैंडिंग? इज इट नॉट इंडिकेटेड बाई यू एज दिस? यस. देन हाउ इट कैन बी यू? द फैक्ट दैट यू परसीव द बॉडी एलिमिनेट्स एनी पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ यूअर बीइंग द बॉडी. इफ यू आर द बॉडी यू कैनॉट परसीव द बॉडी. You are perceiving the body because you are the perceiver. You are not the perceived. That is the confusion. That is the aviveka. You perceive something and you take that something to be yourself. That is the mistake. Suppose somebody is suffering. Suppose you perceive the suffering. Now you get all the suffering which he has by confusion. Then what help you can give to him? Right? You cannot even feel compassionate to you also need help. That is how it happens. In the family situation, that is one person is suffering, so everybody else starts suffering, and so the neighbor has to come and help. So it happens like that. Therefore, you should maintain some viveka, some distinction. Then only you can do some help. Similarly, when something is there in the body, suppose I cut my finger, I should maintain that viveka. The finger is different, I am different. I am the conscious being, I am the sentience which pervades this body, and the body is my body, I have to take care of it. Now the finger is cut, therefore I look at it as an object and which needs some mending, and I do that. That way you have to do. Some people, when they see blood, they collapse. They cannot see blood. So, that's why when these people want to see the surgical procedure and all that, they ask, can you stand blood and all that? Because he will collapse on the surgical floor. And if he collapses, he has to be treated first, other the patient will be lying there. Therefore, why he should collapse means some sort of silly self-identification. My God, I am blood and blood is me, that kind of some such thing. And so blood is flowing means something unusual, something horrible thing has happened to me. So that kind of some fear, and he collapses. So what he can do? He cannot do anything for himself. So you should maintain that viveka, that distance. So what you take yourself to be cannot be other than you. So you cannot say Atma is limited because you show the body and say Atma is limited. The Sankhyas, Shankara tells the Sankhyas. You show something and try to say something else about some other thing. Atmas are many. Why? Yeah, you see, so many bodies are there. Yeah, so many bodies are there. Therefore, you say bodies are many. Why you say Atmas are many? Yeah, so many people are having so many emotional problems. Okay, so many emotional seats of emotion are many. Why you say Atmas are many? So you show something and then tell about something else. Is that the way to look at things? No. Therefore, whatever is perceived by you, by the fact of perception, that is ruled out to be yourself. Therefore, there is no reason to take any limitation in the Atma. But this gentleman, he has convinced himself that he is limited. Athaye anyatha ato viduhu. He is ignorant of everything, then he can be taught. But he has already convinced himself that he is a limited being, and then now you cannot teach him. So these people, they make a mistake like that. So ye anyatha ato viduhu. They understand different from what is presented here. That means they take themselves to be limited. Atma anantaha, they don't take it that way. They take Atma limited, Santaha. It is a jiva, it is individual, it is limited. Like that they take. Then what happens? Anyarajanaha. Te anyarajanaha. They can never become Swarat. they can never become, you see some people in the society, they say, in the management, they say, you are a follower, you are not a leader, like that they say. Because leadership is something, follower is something else. So, people, general public, they are followers, they are not leaders. They are looking always for some leader. In the political field or in the secular life, they want a leader to come and take care of their problems. And in the spiritual field also, they want a leader. And if Ishvara takes care of their personal problems, nothing like that. They want it that way. Ishvara has to take care of their personal problems. Ishvara has to bathe them and feed some food to them. And then a few other services Ishvara has to do. That is what they expect. So they are followers. Anya Rajanaha. They cannot stand this idea of Swarat. I am the Swarat. The entire universe is in me. I am not a limited being. There is no punyam and papam for me. I am everything. I am God. To say that, one should have some courage. Understanding will come later. First, dhiraha. You must be a courageous person. Dhiraha has meaning of understanding also. But you take the immediate meaning of dhiraha. So, dhiraha amrutatvaya kalpate. One should have that courage at least. First of all, he should have that courage. He is always afraid. Suppose I take myself as God. Then God become unhappy. God will be unhappy. And he will curse me. He is a jealous God. You know? Very jealous God. These gods are very jealous, I tell you. They are very problematic. He will become, if I am God, then God becomes unhappy. Okay, suppose God becomes unhappy. Then what happens? What happens? I have a few desires. And I am afraid of a few things. So finally, it is your desire and fear which will not allow you to know what you are. There it ends. So such people who are given to desires and fear, anya rajanaha, they want somebody else to stand by him. Somebody else must be there. To go into the street, he looks around for some support. He cannot go to the street on his own. So they are followers. So somebody else will be sitting over their heads. They are called kinkaraha. Kinkaro me, sab, what shall I do? Okay, go and dig up a trench there. Okay, sir. So he will go up and dig up a trench. That's kinkaro me, kinkaraha. And this kinkara becomes kainkaryam. Kinkarasya bhavaha kainkaryam. So this kainkaryam is taken as purushartha. That is, dvaita bhavana is like that. So for such people, unless they understand better, till they understand better, they continue to be anya rajanaha. There will be some other boss upon their head in this world, in the other world also. And so, they are not a swarat. Then, te kshaya loka bhavanti. They get some prosperity in this world by God's grace. How long it will remain? It will go away. Kshaya loka. Kshaya means exhausted, transient. Then they gain some heaven. And there is no eternal heaven. Eternal heaven is a big bluff, I tell you. There is no eternal heaven. Heaven is there. You can accept it. But eternal heaven is not acceptable. Because in Mundaka it is said this in so many words. Nastya krutah krutena. Nothing like an eternal heaven. Karmachitaha. Yatha karmajitaha lokaha kshiyate, tatha punyajitaha lokaha kshiyate. So, here you make some effort and gain some advantage, some prosperity. Is it not exhausted? Yes. So similarly, you do a little more effort and gain some punyam and go to heaven. And the same logic, based on the same logic, that heaven will be there for a while, till your virtue is exhausted. That's all. There is no eternal heaven. If there is an eternal heaven, then there is a thing called gate crashing. So you do, you live whatever life you want till 70 or 75, then you say full stop to that. So, and then go to a priest and confess, and then you are now ready for heaven. Or you can even pay some money to the doctor, he will give you a lethal injection, so euthanasia, and just before euthanasia make a confession and remember the lot or whatever, make some prayer, then you get crash into the heaven. So a continuous life of spirituality, all that is unnecessary. So just last minute, some funeral service has to be done carefully, that's all. You have to engage a priest, etc. Payment you can make beforehand, they accept it. So so you do all that in a systematic way, you can get crash. Gati, Gati is in heaven, like that. You know Gati? Okay. So you can get crash. It doesn't matter what is your life earlier. And once you have get crashed, entered into the heaven, it is eternal. It is not like that. Kshaya loka bhavanti. You will go to heaven all right, but you will stay there as long as your virtue lasts. Once it is exhausted, back to the world. As a human being, again some virtue must be there. If you have some virtue, you will come back as a human being. If virtue is not enough, you will come back as a cockroach or a deer or a turkey or whatever. So, kshaya loka bhavanti bhashyakara. Atha punaha ye anyatha ataha uktadarshanat anyatha vaiparityena yathoktameva va samyang na viduhu. Atha then, atha punaha ye whosoever anyatha ataha, different from this, that means uktadarshanat anyatha. So atmaivedagum sarvam, that is the darshanam, that is the knowledge, that is the vision, and he has an understanding opposite to that. Why? Vaiparityena, opposite to that. Why? For two reasons. He has read it but refused to look at it correctly because he is prejudiced otherwise, and so samyak na viduhu. He sees it but doesn't understand properly. He says, Atma is Vishnu. Atma prastat, Atma paschat, Atma adaha, Atma uparishtat. If that Atma is I am that Atma, then I have to open my eyes wide and marvel and wonder and see how it is, how. There is a challenge. And you have to seek that knowledge and you have to know it. If there is an opposite viewpoint, you have to work it out. So it becomes a challenge. It becomes a pursuit. No, no. Atma is Vishnu. Vishnu above, Vishnu below, Vishnu here, Vishnu there. Over. Then what I am? Kinkaraha. Very convenient, you know. Kinkara is very convenient. You have to manage a thing. Manager is a problem. Kinkara is easy. So people want to be kinkaras. Really. People, I see it all the time, they want to be mediocre. They don't want the strength, mediocre. So they come as brahmachari to the Vedanta study, brahmachari. Brahmachari means what? He has renounced everything and came for this. It's not like you. You came for a 1 month study, whereas a brahmachari, he is supposed to be with us all the time. And having come as brahmachari, he learns Rama Shabdam, Ramaha Ramo Rama. When I ask him, you do Hari Shabdam, oh, it is enough. Because we are interested in Vedanta, not in Sanskrit. You are a brahmachari, you have to take challenges and go forward. You have, first of all, you should have perfect command and mastery in Sanskrit. You should be able to write poetry in Sanskrit. Then Vedanta will reveal itself to you. Otherwise, every sentence you need profound knowledge of Sanskrit. He doesn't pursue Sanskrit. Okay. Then some little Sanskrit, some Shabdas, and a little of Kaumudi. One sutra here and one sutra there. He knows sutra, he doesn't know vritti. If he knows vritti, he doesn't know example. That is over. Then Vedanta. Okay. What we will study? Atma Bodha, Tattva Bodha, some reading. Viveka Chodamani. He doesn't study Viveka Chodamani properly. Again, superficially. Brahma Sutra, Chatur Sutri, we have heard. Like that. Some superficial, some mediocre. And so now he is in a hurry to teach. And he is a Mahatma now. People have to respect him. If they do not respect, then he has a problem. They are not respecting. Why they should respect you? Why anybody should respect us? Just because we wear certain kind of clothes? All problems, I tell you. All mediocrity. So you should not be mediocre. You should be Swarat. You take Sanskrit, take it to the end, up to Mahabhashyam, Vyakarana you have to read, up to Mahabhashyam you should read, nothing less than that. One should be like that. Brahma Sutra, all the 550 sutras you should read, not some small. No, we could not read it now. Yeah, there is a full life before you. You could not read it in 3 years. No harm. You can read it in 30 years, but you should read it that way. So, that people, they love smallness. The mind is like that. It is not their fault. The mind plays all sorts of tricks. It says, this small is good. Why big? So, they end up as Anya Rajanaha. So, somebody else will be bossing over you. So, nothing wrong in obeying somebody's command and all that in a worldly situation. The idea is, that is not the idea here, the idea is you will ever remain a limited guy. Always seeking pleasure everywhere and always afraid of something else. That is the limitation. So this kamana and bhayam, the desire and fear won't leave you. That is the idea of Anya Rajanaha. It's not that somebody gives a command and it is wrong to follow it. That is not the spirit. Anyway, so yathoktameva samyang na viduhu, either they don't come to this, or having come to this, they misinterpret it. Atma is Vishnu. That is one example of misinterpretation. Atma is Vishnu, all right, but not the sense in which you say, this Atma is Vishnu. I am the Vishnu. That way it is true. Not in any other way. Te anya rajanaha bhavanti bhashya. Anyah paraha
rajaswami
yeshante. Anya Raja Naste, Anyaha Raja Yeshante, Anya Raja Naha. Anyaha means Paraha. Somebody who is superior to him, Paraha. Somebody is always there superior to you. You go to heaven, then people who are in heaven from earlier times, they are superior to you. Like we come to America. America is superior, but we come here. Having come here, we do not become superior. There are so many other people superior to us. Like in India, they go to Dubai and Kuwait. They get some extra money, which is fair enough. That I can understand. So these people ask him, what you do there? Dubai. He comes back with a camera and a tape recorder. These are the two items, with a camera and a tape recorder. Without camera, he won't come. In fact, he will have a camera in his neck, like Rudrakshmala, it will be dangling. And he will be going in that village. Everybody will be looking at him. And he is having a camera. So, when you came from Dubai, yeah, yesterday I came. So, he takes a few photographs and all that. Somebody asks him, what you do there? He says, I am the ground engineer there. Ground engineer means when some clay is dug up, he puts it on his head and carries from one place to another place. He works for daily wages. Nothing wrong in it. If I have to work for it, I will work, no problem. But he takes himself to be superior. He is superior in India, in that village. But when he comes to Dubai, he is not superior. Anya Rajanaha. He is a pawn in the hands of these contractors and agents, who are like blood-sucking creatures they are. So, Anya Rajanaha. Somebody else will be the Raja. Similarly, you go to heaven, there are Anya Rajanaha. You are going to be a limited being only. They are Anya Rajanaha. Okay, somebody else is the Raja, let him be the Raja. I will live in heaven forever, eternal. Is it so? No. Kinchate kincha kshayyo lokaha yeshante kshayya lokaha. You see that kshaya, the word is kshaya. Kshaya means getting destroyed, getting exhausted. Kshayaha, kshaya, shila. For that shilartham, that another ya will come. So it has the nature of getting exhausted. That shilartham is there. Therefore it becomes a kshaya. జయశీల జయ్య క్షయశీల క్షయ్య క్షయ్య జయ్యౌ శక్యార్థే లైక్ దట్ సడన్ ఐ రిమెంబర్డ్ వన్ పాణిని సూత్రం ఇస్ దేర్ క్షయ్య జయ్య ఎనీవే సో క్షయశీల ది లోకా విచ్ హీ గెట్స్ లోకా ఇస్ సమ్ ప్రాస్పెరిటీ ఇన్ దిస్ వరల్డ్ ఆర్ ఎ హెవెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ డెత్ సో దిస్ లోకా వాట్ ఎవర్ హీ గెట్స్ క్షయ్య ఇట్ డిజాల్వ్స్ ఇట్ జస్ట్ డిజాల్వ్స్ suppose you get some money, some unexpected money, windfall, $1 million. The funny thing is it dissolves. There are hawk-like people will be waiting for you. Everybody knows that you have $1 million. 1,000 people will know that you have $1 million. And so they will be coming at you. They will phone, they will send emails, the person will come. All sorts of things they do. And somehow they take away this $1 million. Generally, because a pauper, he doesn't have any money, his credit is zero, then nobody will look at him, they will keep quiet. If he earns another $1 million, again all of them will come. So, kshaya loka, whatever you get, it is transient, it will go away. Nothing is permanent. Only atma jnanam is the permanent thing. That is the idea. No, the purpose is not to denigrate something else. It is all vyajaninda. Something else is denigrated. The idea is, the superior thing is there, that is your own swarupa, know it. That is the idea. Bheda darshanasya alpa vishayatvat alpanchatan martyam ityavochama. So Shankara connects this kshaya to yan martyam yad alpam tan martyam. He connects to martyam. Martyam means mortal. Martya, mortal. English, Sanskrit. Very close. Anyway, so, this yad alpam tan martyam. Whatever is small, it is going to disappear. It is going to disintegrate. This we have seen earlier. Yad bhuma tat sukham, yad alpam tan martyam. Therefore, this person is a limited being. He is an Anya Raja. He has got another superior person sitting over his head. And he takes himself to be a limited being by false identification with the body and all that. Therefore, his bheda darshana, he has this vision of plurality. And he takes the plurality to be real. Therefore, in this vision of plurality, taking the divisions as real, it is alpa vishayatvat. Its domain is alpa. So your vision is alpam, alpam is small. And whatever is alpa, tanmartyam, yad alpam tanmartyam. This is the thesis, the major proposition of the entire khanda is yad bhuma tat sukham, yad alpam tanmartyam. As long as you take yourself to be a limited being, there is no salvation for you, no way. You will be in the clutches of desire and fear. Once you understand your infinite nature, you are liberated. That is, in that infinite nature alone, there is happiness. There is no happiness elsewhere. So this way, that is the main thesis. That's why these people who are the Dvaita Darshins, so whose vision is given to plurality as real, so these people are bound to be having that prosperity for a while. Kshaya loka, that too, if they follow the life of Dharma. If life of Dharma is not followed, then we need not even talk about them. They are doomed for suffering only. So Bhashyakara concludes it. Tasmadye dvaita darshinaha te kshaya lokaha swadarshananu rupye naiva bhavanti ata eva atesham sarveshu lokeshu అకామచారో భవతి. సో దీస్ ద్వైత దర్శిన ఏ అన్యథా అతః విదుః. సో దోస్ హూ డు నాట్ నో ది అండర్లయింగ్ యూనిటీ యాజ్ ది ట్రూత్, సో అండ్ దే టేక్ ది నామరూప యాజ్ రియల్, సో ద్వైత దర్శిన దే ఆర్ కాల్డ్. ద్వైత ఈజ్ నాట్ డ్యూయల్, మీన్స్ ప్లూరల్. సో దే టేక్ ది డివిజన్స్ యాజ్ రియల్. మెనీ పీపుల్ డూ దట్. దే హ్యావ్ సమ్ ఐడియా ఆఫ్ ఎ డివిజన్. For some people, the division is based on caste. For some others, the skin, the color of the skin. the basis of division. For some people, gender is the basis of division. For some people, age is the basis of, we are young people, they are old guys, something like that. So for some people, nationality, we are Americans, we are Indians, this kind of a nationality. So something or other is taken into account, and that becomes the basis of division. They can never rise above this dividing line. So they live in this division, they take the division as real, they are the people. Dvaita Darshinaha. That is how Dvaita Darshinaha is under. It's a very practical thing. It's not some bookish philosophy or anything. So they are committed to division. Dvaita Darshinaha. So te kshaya loka. Their prosperity or whatever they get out of their effort, it will be there for a while and then dissolves. Why so? Swadarshana anurupyenaiva. That is how their darshanam, their understanding is like that. So, if you pass BSA, then you become some clerk in an office. If you do PhD, then you become a professor in the same college. So why so? Why so means according to their knowledge, their understanding, they become that. So nothing wrong in it, but then that is how things are. So similarly, you take division as real, therefore desire and fear will always be with you. They never go away. So swadarshananurupyenaiva, the result will be always in accordance with the understanding of the person. Therefore knowledge liberates and ignorance binds. Ataeva tesham sarveshu lokeshu akamacharo bhavati. For a jnani, he is all, therefore all is his. Therefore all joy belongs to him. So the heaven's joy, the earth's joy, some other joy, whatever joy you talk of, it belongs to him. It is included in his joy. Whereas for the Dvaita Darshinaha, for the people who take division as real, for him something is there and everything else is not there. That a small little thing is there and everything else is denied to him. Therefore, they cannot have that kama sarvesha lokeshu kamacharo bhavati. That won't be there for him, for those people, for the people of limited nature. So then what happens to them? Sarvesha lokeshu akamacharo bhavati. They cannot have all the joy of all levels of existence. They can have some joy which is limited in their small sphere. So that is the negative statement. Once again, the negative statement is aimed at glorifying that jnanam. Iti Shri Chandogyopanishadi Saptamadhyayasya Panchavimshah Khandaha. So we have finished the 25th khanda, now 26th. Tasya hava etasya evam pasyataha evam manvanasya evam vijanataha आत्मतः प्राणः आत्मत आशा आत्मत स्मरः आत्मत आकाशः आत्मतस्तेजः आत्मत आपः आत्मत आविर्भावतिरो भावौ आत्मतोन्नम् आत्मतो बलम् आत्मतो विज्ञानम् आत्मतो ध्यानम् आत्मतश्चित्तम् आत्मतसंकल्पः आत्मतो मनः आत्मतो वाक् आत्मतो नामा आत्मतो मन्त्राः आत्मनः कर्माणि आत्मत एवेदम् सर्वमिति. That is the ultimate mantra. So tasya hava etasya. Why is indeed tasya etasya? Of that this person. That this person means the way atmajnanam is described in a elaborate way, and he appreciates it, he knows it. How? Evam pasyataha. His vision is this way, in this way, thus he sees. Evam pasyataha. What is the vision? The nama rupa, the divisions, are superficial, they are unreal. If you look at the ocean, there are all kinds of divisions. This is south, this is west, they say. This is bay, this is Chesapeake Bay. Then it is Atlantic. It is all your funny divisions. There are no divisions in the ocean. Ocean is one. And you call it bay. You call it south, you call it west. Ocean has no such divisions. So similarly, you say these are waves, these are breakers, these are surf, this, that. These surf people, you ask them, they say, oh, this ocean is useless. You come to our ocean in California, there it is wonderful. That is what he says. For him, this ocean is, so all small little mind. So all divisions are taken into account. That is division. Whereas, here is a jnani who just raises above all these divisions. No division. Sarvam kalvidam brahma. Everything is Atma. There is no enemy. There is no friend. All is divinity. All is Ishvara. All is prana. So, for that is his vision. Evam manvadasya evam vijanataha. Tri shravana manana nididhyasana. So, that is a Brihadaranyaka style. This Chandogya style, Pashyataha Manvanasya Vijanataha. This is style. So Pashyataha means knowing. How he knows? Mananam Vijnanam. They support. So if any doubts are there, they are taken care of by reflection. And the wrong orientations are neutralized by Vijnana, means Nididhyasana. So the vision settles down. Or the person settles down in his vision. One has to settle down, like Rasagulla. Or like a gulab jamun. The gulab jamun settles down in that syrup. And then it becomes complete, purnam. Wherever you touch the gulab jamun, in whichever part you touch, it oozes sweetness. So similarly, this person settles down in it. Evam pashyataha. How he could manage this settling down? Vijanataha, manvanasya, not easy. The vision of unity is not easy. The mind revolts like anything. The circumstances are in the mind only, finally. So, the vision of unity, ragadvesha, they just go against it. Ragadvesha are very powerful. People, even they take to sannyasa and then become the victims of ragadvesha. They will not be able to rise above the ragadvesha. And they will be complaining all the time. This is not there, that is not there. He is like this. He is like that. All. When you are away from the teaching, that is how what happens. So, that he doesn't allow to take place. He settles down into that vision. Evam pashyataha, evam manvanasya, evam vijanataha. Then, for him, Atma is the source of everything. Everything is from Atma. Everything means everything. That's why I quite often say, all blessings come from Atma. All blessings. Even when you take that the grahas are blessing you, those grahas are part of the Atma. God is blessing you, God is part of the Atma. God is in consciousness, you know. So, everything is Atma. Atma, when we say, we do not mean the small little ego. We do not mean the body, etc. Atma is Brahma. Atma is not your son-in-law or brother-in-law. Atma is Brahma it is. It is Purnam. It is everything. And that reflects here. You are not the body and mind. You have grievously mistaken of yourself. You are the infinite. Focused here. That is Atma. That infinite is Atma. That's why if there is life here, if there is life in this body, that life has originated from Atma. Atmata pranaha. If there is hope in this life, and that hope makes people live. People live by hope. Suppose, for some reason, he loses all hope, then very soon he goes into depression, no medicines will work, and he will die. Hope is there. You create hope in any patient of depression, just create a little hope, he will rise above that. These drug addicts, etc. are there, alcoholics, etc. So, the entire, they want to overcome that withdrawal pains, but they should have hope of overcoming it. If he thinks, no, I cannot do that. I can't hope to come out of this paroxysm of withdrawal symptoms. If he doesn't have hope, you know what he will do? He will sneak out from the institution and do something. People even commit murders. So crimes they do, just like that they do crimes. And they do anything. And they go back into their old style. They know that police will catch. But the police is, police can be a threat for a person who has hope. For a suicide bomber, army cannot be a deterrent, you know. You cannot say, I will kill you if you come forward. He is ready for it. So how you can threaten him? How you can put any kind of deterrent for him? There is no deterrent for him. Because he doesn't hope to live. Hope is everything. And this hope, if it has to come into life, atmata asha, it comes from atma. Atmata smaraha, memory. Memory is a wonderful faculty. It is like you are keeping half a dozen gigabyte hard disks in your mind. That is what you are. Memory, the amount of memory that you have, amazing memory. You need not do any defragmentation and all that. It happens on its own. Everything is organized perfectly. Certain things are dumped. Certain other things are picked. Everything is stored in its appropriate place. Nothing is stored in the wrong place. Everything is stored. It's a memory. It's a great faculty. Where from it is coming this power of memorizing atmataha, atma, chaitanyam. From the chaitanyam alone it comes. I say all the time here, I am atma brahma. That is hurdayam it is. So atmata asha, atmata akashaha, space. You think space is outside. There is no space outside. Space is in chaitanyam. You are seeing a movie, a cinema. In the cinema space is there, right? Suppose a plane is taking off. There must be a wide, long runway for the plane to take off. Now the plane is taking off on the screen. Plane is taking off, right? That means that much space, a wide, long runway must be available. It is there. It is taking off. Otherwise, how it will take off? It is there. It is taking off. Okay. Now you tell me, where is that space? On the screen? Then? Where is it? In your mind it is there. Just I give you an example where space is there. In dream, you go and you go to Australia and came back. Whereas, if you take the physical space, then you are lying on a cot. 5 feet long cot or 6 feet long cot, you are lying on it. And you have taken off, crossed oceans and came back. So that space, in dream it appeared real, you know. It is real in dream only. In dream only, when you come out of it is unreal now, but at that time it is not unreal. So at that time that space, where is it? In your mind, in you. Atmata, all space lies in consciousness. It is a wrong notion that space is outside. There is no observer. Can there be space? You ask Einstein, he will tell you that space is in the observer. Space is not outside. Time is not outside. Time is in the observer. Einstein doesn't tell objects are in the observer. He tells only this much. Space and time is in the observer. But he concludes that way. All those conclusions, they coincide. Anyway, so, atmataha akashaha. Atmatastejaha. Tejaha is fire. It originates from Atma, because Akasha itself originates from Atma. Tasmadvaya tasmat Atmanaha Akasha Sambhutaha. Atma is not this small little physical body. Atma is the existence and Satta and Spuranam, awareness. That is Atma. Existence come awareness. That is Atma. Therefore fire is existing and it is shining. Therefore it is Atma. So, atmatastejaha, atmata apaha, same atma when it is reflected in particular conditionality of gunas, it is called apaha, waters. So, apaha, the same sequence which we have seen, let us see bhashya. Tasya hava, etasye tyadi, swarajyam praptasya, prakrutasya, Vidusha ityarthaha. So tasya hava etasya. Who is this tasya hava etasya? That this person of shashti. Tasya hava etasya means స్వరాజ్యం ప్రాప్తస్య ప్రకృతస్య విదుషః ఇత్యర్థః. సో ది ఎంటైర్ స్టేట్మెంట్ విచ్ ఫాలోస్ దిస్ తస్య హవా ఏతస్య, ఇట్ డిస్క్రైబ్స్ ది సిచ్యువేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ జ్ఞాని విదుషః, ఆఫ్ ఎ జ్ఞాని వైజ్ పర్సన్, స్వరాజ్యం ప్రాప్తస్య హూ ఇస్ అనాయింటెడ్ ఇన్ ది సోవరైంటీ ఆఫ్ ఆత్మన్, ఆత్మ సామ్రాజ్య అధినేత. సో హూ సీస్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇన్ ది ఆత్మ, దట్ ఈజ్ వాట్ హీ ఈజ్. సో ఫర్ దట్ జ్ఞాని, సో వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్, ప్రాక్ సదాత్మ విజ్ఞానాత్ స్వాత్మన అన్యస్మాత్ సత ప్రాణాదేహ నామాంతస్య ఉత్పత్తి ప్రళయౌ అభూతాం సదాత్మ. ఓకే, సో ఇన్ఫ్యాక్ట్ శంకర హీ త్రోస్ న్యూ లైట్ ఎవ్రీ టైమ్ యూ లుక్ ఎట్ ఇట్, వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్ థింగ్స్ హీ టెల్స్. యు సీ హీ కనెక్ట్స్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ విత్ ది టెక్స్ట్, దెర్ ఈజ్ ఎ కంటిన్యూటీ ఇన్ ది టెక్స్ట్. సమ్టైమ్స్ ది స్పీకర్ మే రైజ్ అబౌట్ ది టెక్స్ట్ అండ్ హీ మే టాక్ హీర్ అండ్ దేర్, బట్ శంకర కీప్స్ విత్ ది టెక్స్ట్. హీ టేక్స్ బ్యాక్, టేక్స్ అస్ బ్యాక్ టు ది టెక్స్ట్. హీ సేస్ యు సీ సదాత్మ విజ్ఞానాత్ ప్రాక్, ఆత్మా ఇస్ ది సత్, షష్ఠాధ్యాయ, హీ రిఫర్స్ టు షష్ఠ, హీ నెవర్ ఫర్గెట్స్ ది షష్ఠాధ్యాయ బికాస్ వీఆర్ ఇన్ ది సెవెంత్, యు నో. సో సత్ సదేక ఏవ ఇదమగ్ర ఆసీత్, సదేకమేవ ఇదమగ్ర ఆసీత్. సో బిఫోర్ దిస్ క్రియేషన్ దేర్ వాజ్ ఓన్లీ సత్, ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్ అబ్సల్యూట్. దెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ ది క్రియేషన్ సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్ హెస్ కమ్ ఆర్ వాట్? నో, ఆఫ్టర్ ది క్రియేషన్ ఆల్సో ది సేమ్ సత్ కంటిన్యూస్ టు బీ, బట్ ఇట్ అపియర్స్ టు బి సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్, నామరూప. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ లైక్ బిఫోర్ నెక్లెస్ వాట్ వాస్ దేర్ గోల్డ్, ఓకే బిఫోర్ నెక్లెస్ ఇట్ వాస్ గోల్డ్, బట్ ఆఫ్టర్ నెక్లెస్ వాట్ ఇట్ ఈస్, ఇజ్ ఇట్ నాట్ గోల్డ్? ఎస్, బట్ సమ్ హౌ ఫర్ అన్ ఇగ్నోరెంట్ పర్సన్ గోల్డ్ ఈజ్ కవర్డ్ అప్. సో నామరూప కవర్ అప్ ది రియాలిటీ, హిరణ్మయైన పాత్రేణ ఇట్ గ్లెట్టరింగ్ నామరూప సత్యశాపి హితం ముఖం, ద ట్రూత్, ది ఫేస్ ఆఫ్ ది ట్రూత్ ఈజ్ కవర్డ్ అప్. సో ది నెక్లెస్ ఈజ్ గ్లిటరింగ్, ఇట్ అడ్రస్సెస్ యువర్ డిజైర్, ఇట్ ఫిట్స్ ఇన్ టు యువర్ సిల్లీ వాల్యూ సిస్టమ్, దేర్ ఫోర్ యూ లుక్ ఎట్ ది నెక్లెస్ అండ్ ఫర్గెట్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గోల్డ్. సో సిమిలర్లీ ద సేమ్ సత్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఇన్ ది ఎంటైర్ యూనివర్స్. కార్యం అస్తిత్యేవ గృహ్యతే, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ శంకరా సేస్ ఇన్ కఠోపనిషత్. వాట్ ఎవర్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఈస్ దేర్, యూ టేక్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అస్థి ఆర్ అదర్వైజ్, హౌ డు యూ టేక్ ఇట్? టేక్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అస్థి. అస్థి మీన్స్ ఈజ్. సో అస్ ఇన్ సంస్కృత్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అస్. తీజ ప్రత్యయం, తీ కేమ్ భవతి, తీజ ప్రత్యయ, ఇట్ ఈస్ అ సఫిక్స్. ద వెర్బల్ రూట్ ఈజ్ అస్, దట్ అస్ బికేమ్ ఈజ్, దట్ ఈజ్ హౌ ఇట్ ఈస్. ఎనీవే, సో అస్థి, యు టేక్ ది కార్య, ది ఎఫెక్ట్, ది లిమిటెడ్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ యాజ్ అస్థి. ఆర్ డూ యూ హ్యావ్ సర్టన్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ నాట్ క్వాలిఫైడ్ యాజ్ అస్థి? నో, దెర్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ విచ్ ఈజ్ నాట్ అసోసియేటెడ్ విత్ అస్థి. అండ్ దట్ అస్థి, దట్ అస్తిత్వం, దట్ ఈస్ ది సత్. That sat alone is manifesting as different objects because of the gunas. So that is sat, and that sat happens to be you, tatvamasi, tatvamasi, sa atma tatvamasi shvetaketo. So this truth is not known, sadatma vijnanat prak, he doesn't know this truth. Then what he will do? He takes himself to be a limited person. When I am a limited person, I see a few things around me which are superior to me. Svatmanaha anyasmat. So they are superior to me. For example, prana. I am here and prana is there. Prana is the universal purusha. And so I seek something for that, from that prana. I am a permanent seeker. Because we live in the background of desire and fear. Why? Because we are limited in nature. That is how we take. When I am limited, then I have desire and fear. So I need somebody to take care of my desires and somebody to protect me from fear. And that somebody could be prana. Therefore, I do the upasana of the prana. That is the really highest upasana. But it can come down to the level of nama also. There are many steps in between. సో ప్రాణాదేహ నామాంతస్య దెన్ దిస్ ప్రాణ అండ్ అప్ టు నామ దే హ్యావ్ ఎ బర్త్ అండ్ ఎ డెత్. ప్రాణ ఇస్ నాట్ పెర్మనెంట్, ఇట్ కమ్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ గోస్. ఎట్ ది టైమ్ ఆఫ్ క్రియేషన్ ఇట్ మేనిఫెస్ట్స్ అండ్ ఎట్ ది టైమ్ ఆఫ్ ఎనైహిలేషన్ ఇట్ గోస్ బ్యాక్ ఇన్ టు ఈశ్వర. సో ఉత్పత్తి ప్రళయౌ అభూతాం, దట్ ఈస్ ది ఆవిర్భావ తిరోభావౌ ఇన్ ది మంత్ర. సో అండ్ సో ది పర్సన్ హీ టేక్స్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ టు బి ఎ లిమిటెడ్ బీయింగ్, అండ్ సో హీ గెయిన్స్ సంథింగ్ అండ్ హీ లూజెస్ సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్. ఎవరి గెయిన్ ఈజ్ అసోసియేటెడ్ విత్ ఎ లాస్. లైక్ దట్ దిస్ సంసార కంటిన్యూస్. దిస్ ఈజ్ దిస్ వాజ్ హిస్ సిచ్యువేషన్ ఎర్లియర్ టు ఆత్మజ్ఞానం. దెన్ సదాత్మ విజ్ఞానే తూ సతీదానీం స్వాత్మత ఏవ సంవృత్తౌ తథా సర్వే సర్వః తథా సర్వః అప్యన్యో వ్యవహారః ఆత్మత ఏవ విదుషః. That was the situation of a limited being who takes himself as a limited being. Now, idanim, now, sadatma vijnane sati. He has gained the knowledge of atma, which is sat. Atma is this sat. That vijnana he has known. Now what happens, you know, svatmata eva samvruttau. So, utpatti pralaya. So, the birth and death, they happen from atma only. The birth from atma, the death into atma. Everything is atma. Necklace is born from gold. Necklace is resolved into gold. Like that. Everything is atma. There is nothing other than atma. So avirbhava tirobhavau. There is nothing like birth and death. Avirbhava means appearance is birth. Tirobhava, non-appearance, disappearance. That is death. So that we take as death. But these two happen from atma only. Suppose you go to sleep, what happens to the world? It resolves in atma. You come out of sleep, what happens to, where from this world comes out? From atma. Everything is from atma. Prana from atma. Asha, hope from atma. Everything. So sarvopi anyo vyavaharaha vidushaha atmata eva. All this manifestation, namarupa vyakaranam, the manifestation of names and forms in its entirety is from Atma for a jnani, not for other people. Other people, the vyavahara is from God, somebody says from elsewhere, but for a jnani, everything is from Atma. We'll continue. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతి. హరి ఓం శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః. హరి ఓం తత్సత్. శ్రీకృష్ణార్పణమస్తు.